Hi viewers, welcome to my channel Sudha Biology. If you are watching for the first time, please subscribe and press the bell icon. And for today's session, I would like to discuss about environmental sex determination. So, if the sex is determined, that is, the sex of an offspring is determined by environmental factors, then it is called as environmental sex determination. So, in the previous session, we have been discussed about haplodiploidy type as well as genetic balance as well as chromosomal sex determination. So, coming to environmental sex determination, the sex of an offspring is determined by environmental factors. So, that is called as environmental sex determination. So, before going into that, I would like to tell you a few definitions of this. That is, epigamic sex determination, syngamic sex determination, as well as progamic type of sex determination. So, that is, epigamic type of sex determination means, if the sex determination is after the fertilization, that means after the process of fertilization, if the fertilization has been completed and after that the sex of an offspring is determined, then it is called as epigamic type of sex determination. Example, Crocodula, which is a marine mollusk, and Bonilia, so which is also a marine worm. So these are examples for epigamic type of sex determination. And next, syngamic type of sex determination, that is, the name itself says it is during syngamy. If the sex determination occurs during the process of syngamy or during the process of fertilization, then it is called as syngamic type of sex determination. It is seen in most of the plants as well as animals. So that is syngamic type of sex determination. And next, progamic type of sex determination. So, progamic means before the process of fertilization. If the sex determination is before fertilization, then it is called as progamic type of sex determination. It is seen in honeybee. And now, coming to this environmental sex determination, which we are going to describe about Crocodula, which is a marine mollusk, as well as Bonilia, which is a marine worm. So this shows epigamic type of sex determination, and here the environmental sex determination is going to work. So let me tell you, a marine mollusks, okay, as well as that is Crocodula and marine worm Bonilia. So this is a marine worm and this is marine mollusk. Crocodula as well as Bonilia. Bonilia is marine worm. So now this shows epigamic type of sex determination. That is sex determination after the fertilization. So after the process of fertilization, the egg which changes into larval form, after the process of fertilization, the larval form is produced. That is after fertilization, the larval form is produced. Okay, and this larval form, if it is reared individually, if it is reared individually without the parent, so if it is reared or developed individually then it develops into a female offspring, okay, that is female progeny or female offspring. If it is reared alone or if it is reared individually, okay, if it is grown individually, if it is developing individually, it develops into female offspring. And if the larval form, that is, if the larval form is developing on the female parent, is developing on the fully developed female parent. Okay, on the female parent as a parasite. Okay, it is developing on the female parent as a parasite. Then that larval form would be developing into male. So I'll tell you the reason why it is developing into male. Okay, so if the larval form is developing on the female parent as a parasite, it is going to develop into male. So the reason is the larval form which is present inside, which is present along the male, along the female parent, it is going to release some hormones into the female parent and it is suppressing the maleness. It is suppressing the femaleness. So it is developing into male character. Okay, that is male progeny is developed. That is, this larval form releases hormones. This larval form releases some hormones into the female parent. So the femaleness is suppressed there and male progeny is developed. So the larval form releases some hormones into female parent. So it is releasing some hormones into the female parent. So there it suppresses the maleness and so the offspring which is going to develop will be male. So that is how this is. After fertilization, the larval form which is formed, if it is reared individually, if it is developing individually, it develops into a female offspring. But if it is growing along with the female parent as a parasite, it is going to release some hormones into the female parent. As it is releasing some hormones into the female parent, that hormones will suppress the femaleness and so the male character will be developed, that is male progeny will be developed. So that is example for epigamic type of sex determination. Okay, so that is the environmental one example which we can take under environmental sex determination. Okay, that is as a parasite or if it is living alone. So this is one more factor which can be taken as example, that is environmental sex determination. And next we have few more examples like crocodile and lizards. That is one more example we can take for environmental sex determination, that is crocodiles and lizards. Okay, so crocodile as well as and lizard. So one more example for environmental sex determination. So if these crocodiles were after fertilization, so after the process of fertilization, then if this crocodile as well as lizards, especially when these eggs are incubated, when these eggs are incubated at high temperature, it develops into male. So the fertilized egg, so after fertilization, the fertilized egg when it is incubated, that means when it is incubated at high temperature, when the fertilized egg is incubated at high temperature, it develops into a male. If it is incubated at low temperature, then that is going to develop into female. Okay, so that is if fertilized egg incubated, if it is incubated at low temperature, at low temperature, it develops into female. But in case of turtles, it is going to be quite opposite. That is, in case of in case of turtles. If the fertilized egg is incubated at high temperature, egg incubated at high temperature. If the fertilized egg is incubated at high temperature in case of turtles, it is going to develop into a female. So this temperature will be around 33 degrees. So high temperature, that is greater than 33 degrees. So if the fertilized egg, it is incubated at low temperature, if the incubation is at low temperature, that is even less than 28 degrees, okay, if it is less than 28 degrees, now this is going to develop into male. Okay, so this is quite opposite from crocodiles and lizards. So in case of crocodiles and lizard, so the fertilized egg, even this is also example for epigamic. So fertilized egg incubated at high temperature develops into male, and fertilized egg incubated at low temperature develops into female. But in case of turtles, the fertilized egg incubated at high temperature, that is more than 33 degrees, it will be developing into female. And if it is less than 28 degrees, it is going to develop into a male. And if it is between 28 and 33 degrees temperature, that means in between 28 to 33 degrees, then a few individuals, half of the individuals will be male and half of the individuals will be female. So half male and half you are going to get, that is female. So these are all the examples we can take under environmental sex determination, which is also showing epigamic type of sex determination, that is after the fertilization the sex is being determined. So in syngamic type of sex determination, which can be seen in most of the plants as well as animals, during the fertilization itself, okay, the sex is determined. So due to the chromosomal distribution. And next, progamic. So sex determination is before fertilization. Okay, so that is in case of honeybee, we'll see. So thank you for this session.